Okay. Deficiencies in existing tax system, part A, traders. Done. Part B, we are learning it from manufacturing angle. As a manufacturer, how many taxes usually he used to pay? See, he used to pay so many taxes, but we are taking few of only national level taxes and some examples of state level and domestic level. Okay. Majorly, we are concerned about national level, that means central level taxes. As a manufacturer, what will you do now? As a manufacturer, you will purchase some goods from your Maharashtra, but that will not be a finished goods now. That will be your raw material, because manufacturer doesn't purchase finished goods, he will purchase raw material. He can also purchase some raw material from Gujarat, Kerala, Karnataka, other states, right? He can also have some services. Why? As a manufacturer, what kind of services you will take? Again, banking, transportation, insurance, security guard at factory, right? Cleaning, housekeeping, chartered accountant, cost accountants, company secretary, advocate, right? Marketing, designing, packaging. If he doesn't own machinery, then leasing of machineries. If doesn't own this factory, then leasing out of factory, let out of factory, he'll take it on hire, right? All these are input services. Whenever you take services, you have to pay service tax, Swachh Bharat says, Krishi Kalyan says. Whenever you purchase goods, raw material, you have to pay excise duty, CST, local body tax. Whenever you purchase intrastate goods, you had paid excise duty, VAT and LBT. Am I clear? Yeah. I'm adding few more things here. You will also purchase capital goods here. Now, capital goods are very important in case of manufacturer. Capital goods, beta means plant and machinery. Now, do you purchase capital goods to sell it?
No.
You don't sell capital goods here. You put it in your factory and you manufacture goods. That means, are you consumer or customer? But you are purchasing these goods to sell raw material, right? And that's why, see, capital goods is capital goods for you. But capital goods is normal finished goods for somebody. Right? That means that guy must have charged. Person who has sold these capital goods to you, he must have charged excise duty plus VAT. Okay? And plus entry tax, but I'm not putting that again and again here. But these two taxes must be there. Sir, why that person has charged excise duty? Because he manufactured plant and machinery. Why did he charge VAT? Because he sold that particular thing in your Maharashtra. Okay. At the same time, so these two taxes you will pay minimum. More than this possible, but minimum these two. One more item I am taking here. Imported raw material. Imported input, that is a raw material,
foreign raw material. So you are taking some raw material from Mauritius, some raw material from Russia, right? Japan, China, possible Pakistan, Nepal, Bhutan, right? Some raw material you are taking from foreign country. Now whenever you bring raw material from foreign country, what kind of taxes you will pay, beta? So I'm giving you some names. You don't have to learn about it. It's not there in your syllabus, but understand, just try to understand.
We pay basic custom duty.
CD means custom duty, basic means basic.
Okay. We also pay CVD under section 3.1. It represents excise duty.
You understand, CVD means excise duty.
So we will pay excise duty also.
Okay. Because it is not manufactured in India, but it is getting used in
India. Okay, there is a logic behind it, very nice logic. I'll try to explain. We also pay CVD 3.5 under section
3.5. So this is another CVD. CVD means countervailing duty. Some people, if they don't understand it, for you they say this is basic custom duty, this is additional custom duty, and this is special additional custom duty. Basic custom duty, additional custom duty, special additional custom duty. All these are custom duties. Okay. Not only this, apart from this, we pay protective duty, we pay safeguard duty, we pay anti-dumping duty, we pay education cess, secondary higher education cess. So there are more than these custom duties. But at your level, you are not expected to learn other custom duties. But understand, we don't pay only basic custom duty when you import goods in India. So there are so many custom duties. Yes, you tell me, why are they charging so many custom duties on you? Government is happy when you import goods?
No,
they are very sad. Why? Because first of all, you are killing my domestic industry. In Diwali, which lighting you purchase? Domestic lighting or imported lighting? That means you purchase are having musti to pay purchase for foreign goods, right? Now China wants to break Indian economy, and that's why they are literally dumping goods on India. So 20 rupees, 30 rupees, they are exporting to India, and in India you are getting at 100 rupees. Whereas if you manufacture that lighting in India, same lighting, that is not rocket technology, right? Lighting you can purchase, and you can look at the composition of wiring and everything, and you can also start manufacturing. But if you manufacture, the cost will go beyond 500 rupees. And they are selling from China to India, and you are getting it at 100 rupees even after imposing so many custom duties. Okay, why? Because their country, China, is helping them. If manufacturing cost is 500 in India, that means manufacturing cost should be around 300, 400 in China. But their government is saying that, dump this particular article on India. Throw this article. I'll give you subsidy. You are a manufacturer. You take subsidy from me, but do not charge to your Indian importer. No excise duty. So every manufacturer should pay excise duty. Chinese government is saying no excise duty. Why? Because you are not selling these goods in China. You are selling these goods in India, no excise duty. You are not selling in India, that's, you are not selling in our country, that's why no VAT. If you sell in China, then you have to pay VAT. But because you are exporting it to India, no VAT. Export duty, do you think that they will charge export duty? China will charge export duty? No. That means China government is not charging export duty. We are charging import duty. China government did not charge excise duty on that goods. We are charging excise duty. But we cannot charge with the name of excise duty. We are charging with the name of countervailing duty. Because Indian manufacturers are paying excise duty. But importers, imported goods, nobody paid excise duty. Because manufacturing states, they are saying that you should not pay excise duty on goods exported. Even we do that. So if goods are exported from India, we are not charging excise duty on that. If goods are exported from Maharashtra, we are not charging VAT on that. This is global tactics to break other economies. Am I clear? But we have to protect Indian manufacturers. So what are we doing? You import goods, they are not charging export duty, you charge import duty. They did not charge excise, although manufactured goods, we are charging excise duty, but excise duty in form of CVD. They sold goods, but they did not charge VAT. We are charging VAT in form of, okay? Sir, steel goods is cheaper in Indian economy. Then charge safeguard duty, protective duty, anti-dumping duty. They are dumping articles. You protect with anti-dumping duty. Am I clear? Customs is not in your syllabus. Still, I explain this much. All right? Why? Because you should understand there is a CVD and CVD. This is not CVD 3.1. You just understand CVD 3.1 is excise duty. And CVD 3.5 is VAT. Representative of VAT. Okay. Alright. So as a manufacturer, we are getting this much input. Can I sell as it is? No. What will I do? I'll do one best process in my factory. And what is this process, sir? This process is equal to manufacture. This process is equal to, and whenever you manufacture in India, you are liable for excise duty. You have to pay excise duty now because you manufactured goods in India. But you will not pay whole excise duty because you had already paid so many excise duties. Can you identify excise duties? Here you paid excise duty. Here you had paid excise duty. That means whether you buy from Maharashtra or whether you buy from Gujarat doesn't matter. Why? Because on both article you had paid. At the same time, even if you buy from Russia, you had paid excise duty. But that name is not excise duty. It is CVD 3-1. But you should get credit. Are you friends? You should get credit of this. Because this is also excise duty, no? This excise duty is available. Sir, what about capital goods available? Capital goods available but in 50-50 ratio. 50% current year, 50% next year. Because capital goods means huge, bulk. In one shot, we cannot give you credit. That's why we were giving you credit. But in two installments. 50% current year, 50%. All these complications are gone in excise as of now. But you should understand this available or not available? Available. Right? Now services. This is also available. Service tax. I paid service tax. Do we have service tax department in India? I told you last time. Why? Because service tax was introduced by entry number 97. And it does not have service tax act. And because it does not have service tax act, it cannot have its own department. That means who is taking care of service tax? That means if you want to pay excise duty, you will go to excise building. And if you want to pay service tax, still you will go to excise building. That means technically from center, who is the owner of excise duty? Central government. Who is the owner of service tax? That means whether it is service tax or excise duty, both you are paying to? That's why credit in excise duty available for? See, while paying excise duty, you will get credit of excise duty. I am saying that government went one step ahead and then say, manufacturer will also get credit of? Service tax can be set off against excise duty. All right, but this is happening at central level. Now what is happening at central level? Turn karna na isko. What is happening at central level? See, this is state level, state level taxes, and this is central level taxes. What is happening at central level? I have to pay which tax to central government? You tell me. Excise. Sir, excise duty is on manufacturing. I manufactured it, I have to pay tax. Which tax? Excise duty payable. Right? On goods manufactured, not on goods sold. On goods? Because sale is not important in excise. What is important in excise? Manufacture, right? This is my gross excise duty payable, but I don't know that how much credit I'll get. So I said that I should get credit of, and credit in form of sen VAT. Why sen VAT? Sen means central. VAT means value added tax. There should not be confusion in this VAT and that VAT, right? That's why they said it is sen VAT. Sen VAT means central value added tax. I don't get credit only of excise duty on input. Can I get this credit, excise duty on input? Will I get this credit, excise duty on input? Yes. Are you not like no? I'm using it, I'm putting this raw material, I'm selling these goods, right? So I'll get credit on this input. At the same time, can I get excise duty credit on capital goods? Yes. Sometime 100%, sometime 50-50. But credit is available. Can I get credit on service tax paid? Right, on input service. Right? I'll get credit on this also. Sir, can I get goods credit on input, imported goods? But that is not known as ED, that is known as CVD under section 3-1. Right? Imported goods. Alright? So I will get credit of all these four against this liability, and I have to compute my net tax liability. Under old system. Alright? Happy? Let me see. You paid maximum major tax, and major tax are available as credit. So central tax is available at central level. Now what happened about this VAT, sir? This VAT. This VAT. And this VAT.
Can I get credit? Now VAT means I paid to? VAT means I paid to? State government. VAT means I paid to? But you know what? I paid this VAT to state government. I paid this VAT to state government. But I did not pay this VAT to state government. I paid it to? That means who will get give me credit? So here you will not get credit of only 3-1. You will also get credit of CVD 3-5. Why? Because, sir, I paid VAT. Usually VAT credit should be given by state government. But have you paid this to state government? Custom duty. Who owns custom? Who is the owner of custom, controller of custom? Central government, state. How do you know? Why central government? Why not state government? No, import duty, but I want constitutional answer. Now, like, don't give me feeling, sir. Central, na, sir. Custom is written at entry number 83 of union list. That's why custom duty we pay to central government. Chiju, AC chalu karna. Do cha student mar gaye saale AC chalu kar. आ रहा है ऑक्सीजन आ रहा है. आर यू क्लियर विद दिस लॉजिक दैट दिस वैट इज नॉट अवेलेबल अगेंस्ट वैट बट दिस वैट इज अवेलेबल अगेंस्ट. दैट मीन्स यू टेल मी एज अ मैन्युफैक्चरर यू आर गेटिंग मैक्सिमम क्रेडिट. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट दिस टू वैट. सर विल आई गेट क्रेडिट ऑफ दिस टू वैट? अच्छा यू पेड इट टू महाराष्ट्र गवर्नमेंट एंड यू विल मैन्युफैक्चर गुड्स. व्हाट विल यू डू आफ्टर मैन्युफैक्चरिंग? सो सेकेंड इवेंट विल बी sale. First event manufacture, second event sale. On manufacturing you paid excise duty, on sale you will pay output VAT. While paying output VAT you will get credit of VAT. So manufacturer is excise duty registered person as well as VAT registered person, and that's why he will get credit of central taxes under CENVAT and he will get VAT credit under VAT law because he is registered under two level. He is registered at state level as well as central. And that's why he gets credit of state as well as central, but under different law, name is also different. State credit is known as input tax credit, whereas central credit is known as CENVAT. But still, after having this much detailed system, still he is not getting credit off. Still he is not getting credit off. Still he is not getting credit off. Credit of CST, LBT, Swachh Bharat says, Krishi Kalyan says was quite, I'm not discussing about Krishi Kalyan says because service provider was getting it and manufacturer was not getting it. So there is a complication. So ignore it, right? So there are still so many tax. Acha, anti-dumping duty. No credit on BCD. See, BCD is not available. Basic custom duty is not available on credit. Out of 9 custom duties, only 2 custom duties are available as credit. What about balance 7, sir? Not available. Right? So what are the challenges? Sir, no CENVAT credit on CST. VAT. CENVAT is not available on VAT. Okay? No CENVAT on or ITC, no CENVAT or ITC on this local body taxes or CST. Okay, understood? Yeah, no CENVAT on Swachh Bharat SES plus other SES. So I am not writing all SES now. There is a clean energy SES. We had paid so many SES. Clean energy SES, clean Ganga SES. Many taxes. Okay. And we were not getting credit. But manufacturing industry was happy even in old law because still these are small taxes here. Major taxes were available as credit. That means GST has not given happiness to manufacturing segment. But GST has obviously given happiness to traders.
Okay, so please write it down, manufacturing segment. Please use the